the stroke program this past summer. My advisor for this program is Douglas Nunnegraff, and my mentors are Yang Wang and Hyun Jun Yun. My project is fabricating a device with micropump. Many microfluidic systems consist of microvalves and micropumps. Microvalves help to direct fluid in the channel, and micropumps control fluid flow. Five major classes of microvalves, and the one we are using is a pneumatic microvalve. Pneumatic microvalves can be further categorized, and we are using normally open microvalves. In this type of microvalves, the fluid flow is hindered when positive pressure is applied. There are two categories of micropumps, active and passive. In pneumatic membrane micropumps, the movement of the fluid is caused by volume displacement. The basic idea behind the device is that this is a three-layer device. As seen from the diagram, the patterns of the first two layers are different. The space between the first and the second layer will be where air enters to actuate the pumps, and the space between the second and glass layer will be the channel where the fluid will flow. The first two layers are made from RTB, but the ratios of the base to curing agent are 5:1 and 20:1 respectively. As mentioned, air will enter and push down the PDMS membrane, thus closing the valves and actuators of pumps. Each micropump will be closed in turn, allowing positive flow and circulation. Now that you know the basic idea behind this device, let me show you how the device is made. The first step is to prepare the second layer and put it in a vacuum for approximately 1 hour. The step will be spin coating using the mixture prepared in the first step. Pour the PDMS onto the wafer previously prepared in the clean room. After spin coating, heat the wafer at 80 degrees Celsius for 40 minutes. Meanwhile, start preparing the first layer. Firstly, cut the PDMS up from the petri dish, and then cut the PDMS into individual pieces for punching holes on the PDMS. The first layer must be made at least 1 day beforehand. The first layer is made by pouring PDMS to silicon wafer, put into vacuum, and then baked at 65 degrees Celsius overnight. After 40 minutes is up, bond the first and second layer using plasma. Here, I'm aligning the first layer to the second layer before bonding them together. Then, heat the bonded layers at 80 degrees Celsius for 40 minutes. After 40 minutes, cut and peel the two layers off the wafer, then punch holes on the PDMS. To minimize the risk of the pumps being bonded to the glass later on, PDMS stamps are put on the pumps area on the glass. Next, bond the two layers to the glass layer using plasma. Ensure that the glass and the PDMS are clean before bonding. If the bonding is strong enough, no heating is required. And this is the final product.